Hey, it's Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. The next episode in the series of Excel turning 40, we're going to take a look at Goal Seek. The 40th anniversary of Excel is September 30th, 2025. All right, Goal Seek debuted all the way back in 1993 in Excel 5.0. It was part of what they called at that point the What If Analysis Toolkit, which is back here under Data, What If Analysis. There's three tools here. Two that I use all the time, Goal Seek and Data Table. We'll talk about those today. Scenario Manager I've used. It's just not as convenient as Goal Seek. All right, so what I have here is I have a nice little model. I want to buy a car, $35,995. I want to pay for it over 60 months, 6.75% annual interest rate. Now, that's the thing that trips people up here when they use the PMT function, because that's an annual interest rate, and we're looking for a monthly payment. That annual interest rate has to be divided by 12. And the price of the car, I make that be negative. That way, my payment is positive. If we didn't make the price of the car negative, this would be a negative number because it's money coming out of your bank, but I just don't like that. It's not like I'm writing a check for negative $708. And actually, I don't want to write a check for $708. I'd rather write a check for, let's say, $625. All right, so if I'm trying to figure out what price will get me to 625, I could play this game where I just start plugging in lower numbers. And in my mind, for those of you who are born of a certain age, you might remember Bob Barker on The Price is Right shouting out higher or lower, right? So here's what we do. Instead of just plugging in numbers and trying to get there, go to the cell that contains the formula. This is the cell that we want to solve for. We want to make this be $625. So we go to Data, What If Analysis, Goal Seek, and we're going to set cell B7, that's the cell that's selected, to, let's say, $625 by changing cell B3. And when I click OK, they're going to try higher and lower numbers and very quickly get to exactly the right number. In fact, it's far more precise than what we're seeing there. So at the four digits in this particular case. So a very quick way to back into an answer. Now I'm going to undo that. It's also possible to, you know, solve for the term or the rate. So if we come here to What If Analysis, Goal Seek, set cell B7 to $625 by changing cell. Let's go with the term. Click OK. All right, so a 67 and a half month loan. I don't know who's going to give you that. Or What If Analysis, Goal Seek, set cell B7 to $625 by changing the interest rate. Ooh, wow, if you just get a promotional interest rate, that would get our price down and get the original car. I was doing a seminar down in Melbourne, Florida recently, and someone said, "Oh, wait, you know, can't you do this another way? What if we needed to solve for the term or the rate?" And yeah, there are four functions here: PV, NPER, rate, and PMT, and you just have to give it the other three. So here to solve for what, how many months of a loan, take the interest rate divided by 12. This time I made the present value, or the payment be negative, and then the present value be positive, and it comes up with 66.53 months. All right, what if we want to change two variables? So I have a model that comes down to a single number down here with a formula. There can be as many formulas as you want, as long as you come down to a single number, and that's the number that we want to change. And I want to take all of these different numbers and plug them into this cell for the term. And I want to take all of these different prices and plug them into this cell for the price. Now, I've color-coded these. You don't have to color-code them. It just helps me to think about it. In the top left corner cell has to be the result that we're trying to model, right? So I'm going to select all of these cells and come out here to Data, What If Analysis, and then a Data Table. And here's how it works. It says the items along the top row, where are we going to plug those in? So that's what they call the row input cell. That's in this case B3. And then the column input cell are for the things down the left hand side. And we'll choose the term there in B4. All right, now this is amazing. I'm going to press OK. And in this case, we have six items down the left-hand side, seven items across the top side. So it's going to run this model 42 times. All right, very quickly get the answers for the various prices and terms. A little bit of formatting here just to make this look interesting. We don't need all those decimal points. And apply a little bit of conditional formatting, color scale, largest numbers in red, right? So if we're going to get that $75,000 sports car and pay for it in 24 months, it's going to be, wow, like a mortgage payment right there, $3,349. Or if we're going with a maybe a used car, a couple years old, pay for it over 72 months, down to $423. And of course, these are all live. If we would change these numbers, it will instantly update. This is an amazing function called the table function. You can't enter this function yourself. You have to use the data what-if analysis data table. So very cool couple of tools that debuted back in 1993 when Excel was less than 10 years old. It's been around for more than 30 years. Make sure to check out all the other MVPs and creators who will be posting a different feature every weekday up until the anniversary of September 30th, 2025. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.